Welcome back into the Sports Source. This segment brought to you by Safety Systems. For more than 15 years, Safety Systems has been the best local bet for home security and business security systems. They also do incredible work with home audio video systems. I needed them to come out and do a little work at my house last week. They met my schedule. They arrived on time. There were no surprises. They are terrific. Visit safetysystems.com. this week, or give J.J. Surlis a call, the former VFL. We'll be sure to get you on their list. Safety Systems. Okay, want to tell you, coming up, special overtime segment today. Follow me on Twitter, and I'll tell you when that's posted online. Our show's posted by about 4 o'clock every Sunday at sportsource.tv and our YouTube channel, so you can check that out. We're going to do an overtime after the show ends today. But it is time for our fast finish, so I want to jump into this. First up, I asked folks on Twitter this week, we did this on the in an overtime segment a few weeks ago, who would we put as a non-conference foe for Tennessee? Here's what some folks on Twitter responded to me. The top vote-getter, Texas, who they most want to see, then Michigan and Ohio State, Clemson, Notre Dame, UCLA, and then others receiving votes. You see that list right there, Hawaii, I think, you know, do a home and home with Hawaii. So folks, I think people would like to travel to Hawaii is the gist. Syracuse, that's got to be somebody just living in Syracuse that wants to see them.
Somebody so, likes orange.
Anyway, then we got, yeah. I also asked to put up a poll, that's the next graphic, and that is Let's Play Win. Asked people, what's the best kickoff time for a Vols football game? 1 p.m., which is the traditional time, I think, 3:30, and then 7:30. Boy, the later the better. 89% prefer 3:30 or 7:30. Mm-hmm. Only 11%, like me, wanted earlier in the day. I don't like noon, but 1 or 2, that'd be great if you get a 2 o'clock game, which no one does because of TV. But in the old days, you'd have that kind of an early start to your afternoon. But the fans going with the later version there. And then I also wanted to mention this very quickly. For those who haven't seen it, there you can go to my Twitter feed. I tweeted this video last night. It's making the rounds. Rick Barnes with TJ Ford, former Texas basketball player down there, left for the NBA 14 years ago, went back this Friday and finished up, well, he finished up his degree this past year, but he went back on Friday to graduate. Rick Barnes returned to Austin, where he was fired, returned to Austin to be there at the graduation for TJ Ford. There's video of the two of them embracing after the graduation, TJ Ford crying, talking about what a father figure Rick Barnes has been for him. It is one of the best recruiting tools you could ever imagine. Chuck, you saw it last night. You got about 20 seconds. You saw it last night.
Jeff Van Gundy is an NBA analyst last night during the Warriors-Spurs game, talked about what a great moment this was and referred to Rick Barnes, the great coach from Texas and Tennessee. And I'm sure that just sent even more people to search it to see exactly what was going on.
Terrific, terrific video. Go find it. I tweeted it last night. You can see it in my timeline. You can Google it, Barnes Ford. You'll find it. Great stuff for Rick Barnes and the Tennessee basketball program. The softball game that I mentioned is at noon. Been postponed to 2:30. 2:30 due to rain, but it's been postponed. See it at 2:30. And then 5 o'clock next Sunday, right back here at Channel 6. But 5 p.m. as we do the Sports Source, talking about the biggest heroes and villains for UT football over the last 15 years since we've been on the air. Thanks for watching. Thanks to all of our sponsors. We'll see you next Sunday, 5 o'clock, right here for the Sports Source.
The Sports Source is brought to you by Fast Frame with Heather Whiteside Art, now available.